Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to look at how we can test our Inertia application using PHPUnit and Laravel. In one of the previous episodes, which I'll link down below, I showed you how to create a registration page using Laravel, Inertia JS, and React. We will be testing the full registration process as well as the Inertia endpoints. And because we use React as our front-end framework, we are not able to use PHPUnit in order to test that. In that case, we might need to look at a different library like Cypress or Laravel Dask to do our end-to-end testing. Okay, so I'm going to quickly show you in the browser what we're going to test today. If we navigate to the /dashboard endpoint, you'll see that this dashboard endpoint sits behind authentication. So we're going to register a user. We are going to automatically log in after our registration, and we're going to display the dashboard. So now if we go to the /register endpoint and complete the fields. Firstly, if we don't complete any fields, you'll see we're going to get validation errors. We're going to test that we get the correct validation errors back. And let's complete our fields. And we register a user. Now, after registration, you see now we are able to automatically log in and navigate to the dashboard endpoint. And this is the complete registration process we're going to test using PHPUnit and Laravel. Now, if we look at our first test, it says it should show the registration page. So basically, what we're going to test is once we hit the get endpoint for the route register, we need to assert that we get a 200 response, which is assert okay. Then we need to assert whether the response is an inertia response. And we do this by calling the assert inertia method on our response. And as a parameter, we pass in a closure function, which basically takes an assertable inertia, which is a test class from inertia, and we pass in the page. And on this page parameter, we then call the component method to assert if the register component is the one we receive. We also check if it has errors, and then we check that this errors is an empty array because we're not expecting any errors on our page. Now, the where method is basically an extension of the has method. The has method only checks whether a certain key is available in the response you check, but the where method checks whether the key has a certain value. Now, before the where key is based or the where method is executed, under the hood, it automatically executes the has method as well. So in this case, we don't need to call the has method first. We only need to call the where method. Okay, so let's save our file and run PHPUnit and see if our test executes. And there we go, we've got one test and 10 assertions. Our registration page shows successfully. Okay, and now for our second test, we're going to check it should return errors when the required fields fail validation. So if we check in on the right-hand side, you'll see all three fields are required. Now, to start off, we call the get method on the register route. This is to simulate that we're landing on the registration page as usual. Then we call our next test method. And our first method we call is the follow redirects. Now we call this follow redirects method because when Laravel validation fails, it automatically redirects you back to the previous page with a 302 error or 302 response code with your validation errors. If we don't follow the redirect, then our test is basically going to stop at this point with a 302 response code instead of the normal 200, which normally happens after the redirect has happened. And we want to test the redirect to the inertia response so that we can test whether the inertia response has the correct error codes to display on our component. Okay, so next what we do is we are posting information to our register route. We are not including any fields because we expect the response to have error codes. And because we are following the redirect, our next response should be okay, which will then display the inertia component, which we're going to assert similar to the previous test. Again, we're going to check to see if we get the auth register component. And then we're going to do three where methods to check whether the name, the email, and the password has got specific error messages. Just a tip, when using the where method, if you have a deeply nested object, you can call the object properties using the dot notation. Okay, so let's run PHPUnit again and see what happens. There we go. We've got two tests and 24 assertions. Our second test was successful. All right, before we head over to the last test, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you found it useful and you would like to see more, please consider subscribing and remember to turn on the notifications. Okay, so for our last test, it should register successfully and then redirect to the dashboard. Now again, if we look at our test, our first method is calling the get method on the route, again, to simulate that we've landed on the registration page. Next, we do a new request, and again, we follow the redirects. We then post the information to our register endpoint, and this time we're actually sending valid data. We then assert that our response is okay, and then we assert again that we receive an inertia response. Now, this time in our inertia response, we need to assert that our landing component after the registration is going to be our dashboard. That's why we are going to assert that it's going to be the dashboard show component. And then we're going to assert that our errors object or prop is empty. And then we're going to see whether the auth user prop or object matches the currently logged in user. Now, the auth user object is an object that Inertia automatically sends every time to every page in your application. And this can be customized. If you go to your handle Inertia request middleware, you'll see that it creates the auth user and then basically just calls the authenticated user and sends it to the front end. Now, this is also where you can add additional data that you absolutely need on every page within your application. You can add it within this section. Just be careful and mindful of the information you send with this method. Because if you send too much information, and because this is sent on every request to every page, it could severely impact the performance of your application. Okay, so back to our test, and we can now save, run PHPUnit again, and see if it's successful. And there we go. We've got three tests, 36 assertions, and our third test was successful. And that is how you can write tests for Inertia using PHPUnit and Laravel. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and see you in the next one.